In the last decade, Greece has become a telling case study in how to respond to a sudden, devastating economic slowdown. In the years since the crisis hit the country in 2010, economic growth has fallen by 25%. A quarter of a million companies have collapsed. Unemployment has jumped from 10% to 25% and to over 50% for young people. At its worst, close to half the population of Greece was living below the poverty line. And one response was a movement of just the kind that David Fleming had advocated.
What means for us solidarity is, first of all, to say that no one is alone in this crisis. We are all together. We stay together, we live together, and we fight together. And that is why we have that written here, Mazi. That means Mazi, together, together, in every situation.
And the situation was particularly bad for medical services, as suddenly doctors and hospitals, prescriptions and treatments all had to be paid for. In response, an informal health service was set up by volunteers across the country. Solidarity clinics were established, like this one in Athens, with doctors and pharmacists offering their time and expertise to anyone who needed healthcare but could no longer afford it. This clinic was founded by the cardiologist, Dr. Yorgos Vikas.
It was at the very beginning of the crisis in 2011 that I had the idea of this clinic. The aim was to help patients who simply couldn't afford healthcare and were at the risk of dying. And if I hadn't done anything, I would have felt complicit. When we opened the clinic, we were just 20 volunteers here, and seven of us doctors. And then, within 6 months, we were 300 volunteers and 100 doctors. At first, we had a few boxes of drugs. Now, we have rooms full coming in as community donations.
Prescriptions are dispensed by pharmacists working in their spare time or by others who are retired.
We see people here who become unemployed because of the crisis or had their pensions cut right back. That's why they come here. So, for example, a person who needs a thyroid pills, this pack only cost 1 euro. But even that's something they can't afford. So I rely on this clinic. Otherwise, it would cost me around 100 euros every month, which I just don't have. It's not a question of charity. This is a political act of solidarity. I retire now, but I can't just stay home watching on television things going on from bad to worse and do nothing. So I worked here for 6 years now with the other volunteers. We make a team, and I hope we make a difference.
And I can't see all the people die around me, because maybe tomorrow I'll be in the same place. That's why we feel so good, all the people here. That's why, in the clinic. It is very difficult for the people who work and they take a lot of money to understand what is this to give without take back money or something else. They can't understand that. But for us, it is very important, because if there are a lot of places like this, this is the hope of the future.